السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أناديه ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه، ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازيه. نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، إلها واحدا أحدا فردا صمدا قيوما، نؤمن له بالربوبية ونقر له بالعبودية. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد، كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والأوصياء والصديقين وعترة نبيك الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين والصفوة الخيرة من أصحابه المنتجبين ومن تبعهم بإحسان وإيمان إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا، هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور وكان بالمؤمنين رحيما. صدق الله العلي العظيم. The most important forms of worship is the remembrance of God. Dhikrullah. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu dhkurullah dhikran kathira. Mawlai bi dhikrika aasha qalbi. The sustainability of the heart and the fuel for the heart and for the soul is the remembrance of God. وروي عنه صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أنه قال: من أكثر ذكر الله أحبه الله. Whoever frequently remembers God, God is going to adore him. ومن ذكر الله كثيرا كتبت له براءتان. And a person who frequently remembers his Lord, he is going to receive two protections and two immunities and two acquittances. One of them is bara'atun min an-nar, immunity against the hellfire. The second, wa bara'atun min an-nifaq, a person who always truly remembers God is going to be protected against hypocrisy too. الإمام الصادق عليه الصلاة والسلام says: شيعتنا إذا خلوا الذين إذا خلوا those who are in private ذكروا الله كثيرا. Always remember their Lord. And we have been told that for everything there is a limit. Everything there is a limit. حد or limit. The prayers, the limits of the prayers when you do the 5 daily prayers. The limit of the mandatory fasting is when you do the 29 or 30 days of the month of Ramadan. The limit of the Hajj is when you go to Hajj. The limit of the zakat when you pay the amount due. إِلَّا الذِّكْرِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَمْ يَرْضَ مِنْهُ بِالْقَلِيلِ. Accept dhikr. Allah says it has no limit, limitless. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا كثيرا, with no limits. وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. A person comes to the Prophet and he says, يا رسول الله, those people in the mosque, who is the best among them. The Prophet رُوِيَ عَنْهُ أَنَّهُ قَالَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ ذِكْرًا لِلَّهِ. The best among them is the one who frequently remembers his Lord. وَرُوِيَ عَنْهُ أَنَّهُ قَالَ مَنْ أُعْطِيَ لِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا. Whoever has been blessed by a tongue that remembers God. This is truly blessing. Some people have been given a tongue to practice ghibah. His tongue is dedicated for ghibah and slandering and bad mouthing. Others, they have been blessed by Allah to use their tongue and their mouth for dhikr, to remember Allah. مَنْ أُعْطِيَ لِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا. Whoever has been given a remembering tongue, a tongue that remembers God, فَقَدْ أُعْطِيَ خَيْرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, then that person has been given all the goodness of this life and the hereafter. أَوْحَى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى لِمُوسَى يَا مُوسَى لَا تَفْرَحْ بِكَثْرَةِ الْمَالِ وَلَا تَدَعْ ذِكْرِي عَلَى كُلِّ حَالٍ. Do not be cheerful with the abundance of your wealth. Do not rejoice and do not leave my remembrance at any circumstances or any condition. Do not forget me. Musa said to the Lord, Ilahi, there are some circumstances that comes. إِنَّهُ يَأْتِي عَلَيَّ مَجْلِسٌ إِنَّهُ يَأْتِي عَلَيَّ مَجْلِسٌ أُعِزُّكَ وَأُجِلُّ أَنْ أَذْكُرَكَ فِيهِ. Sometimes a circumstances comes, you know, that I get embarrassed to mention you when I am in that circumstances. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala awha ilayh, Allah said to him, يَا مُوسَى اِذْكُرْنِي إِنَّ ذِكْرِي حَسَنٌ عَلَى كُلِّ حَالٍ. Whenever, at any circumstances, at any condition, at any position, at any minute, you may remember me because it is good. The remembrance of God never ceases, at any condition. اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. Surah Al-Imran, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ, signs for those who reflect, لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ. Those who always remember God, whether they are standing, whether they are sitting, قُعُودًا, whether they are on their sides, meaning they are laying in bed, but still they do not remember, they do not forget the remembrance of God. وَسُئِلَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ يا رسول الله أي الأعمال أفضل فقال أن تموت ولسانك رطب بذكر الله تعالى. While at the time of death, your tongue is fresh with the remembrance of God. أنا مع عبدي ما ذكرني وتجري بي شفتاه. As long as he remembers me, my servant remembers me, and his mouth and his lips, they utter my name and my remembrance, I am with him. I am protecting him. وَرُوِيَ عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَالَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ قَالَ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي عَبْدِي فِي نَفْسِهِ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِي. When he remembers me privately, I would remember him privately too. وَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَئٍ خَيْرٌ مِّن مَلَئِهِ. And if he remembers me in public, I am going to remember him too in public, that is better than his public, than his group. And the public that God has next to him are the angels. So he's going to remember him with his angels. مَنْ شُغِلَ بِذِكْرِي. This is a powerful hadith. مَنْ شُغِلَ بِذِكْرِي عَنْ مَسْأَلَتِي. Sometimes people during the nights of Qadr, they recite Quran and dua, and they forget to ask for themselves or their families. because they are busy remembering God. The result is من شغل بذكري عن مسألتي أعطيته أفضل ما أعطي من سألني. I am going to provide him the best of what I provide those who ask me. So when you remember Allah, don't worry if you forget to ask something for yourself. Allah does not forget. Allah knows our needs. يعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. Allah knows exactly what we need inside our hearts. So if one day you are remembering him and you forgot to ask him something, he does not forget. He is going to give you and provide you. The Prophet says, ما قعد قوم مقعدا, no community have a session, a meeting, a session. لم يذكروا الله فيه, if they do not remember God. ولم يصلوا على النبي إلا كان عليهم حسرة يوم القيامة. If you sit in a session, no matter whether you are 2 people or 20 or 200, if you do not remember God in that session, and you do not greet the Prophet with saying, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad, you're going to regret that session on the Day of Judgment. You're going to regret that session on the Day of Judgment. وَمَا جَلَسَ قَوْمٌ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Whenever a community gathered to celebrate the remembrance of God, إِلَّا حَفَّتْ بِهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, the angels are going to surround them. وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ, the blessing of the Lord is going to overwhelm them. وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهِ, Allah is going to remember them and mention them with the group that are with him. And Al-Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wassalam says, إِنَّ ذِكْرَنَا مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. When you remember the Imams of Ahlul Bayt, as if you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَذِكْرُ عَدُوِّنَا مِنْ ذِكْرِ الشَّيْطَانِ. And the remembrance and the celebration, when some people celebrate the enemies of the Prophet and his family, they are celebrating the remembrance of Shaytan. That's the difference. وعنه عليه الصلاة والسلام قال من قال في كل يوم. Remember this dua and this dhikr every day. لا إله إلا الله حقا حقا, لا إله إلا الله عبودية ورقا, لا إله إلا الله إيمانا وتصديقا, أقبل الله تعالى عليه بوجهه. Allah is going to face him. وَلَمْ يَصْرِفْهُ عَنْهُ, Allah would not turn his face away. The face means the rahmat, the blessing, not the physical face. God does not have physical face. His blessings and his mercy. وَلَمْ يَصْرِفْهُ عَنْهُ حَتَّى يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةِ, he's going to receive God's blessings and mercy until he enters paradise. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, أفضل ما قلته أنا, the best thing that I said, والنبيون من قبلي, and the prophets before me, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. And then he says, خير العبادة, the best type of service, قول لا إله إلا الله والاستغفار, and then seeking forgiveness from the Lord, because the Lord says, فعلم أنه لا إله إلا أنا وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ. Always remember that there is no God but me, and seek forgiveness for your sins. وعن الصادق عليه الصلاة والسلام من قال عشر مرات, if you say this sentence 10 times before sunrise and before sunset, before sunrise and before sunset, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد, يحيي ويميت ويميت ويحيي, وهو حي لا يموت, بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. If you say this sentence 10 times, كان كفارة لذنوبه ذلك اليوم, this would be an atonement, expiation for your sins of that day. وعنه عليه الصلاة والسلام قال من قال أربع مرات إذا أصبح when you wake up in the morning say four times الحمد لله رب العالمين فقد أدى شكر يومه فقد أدى شكر يومه. You are thanking God for what He has given you in these 24 hours. If you say very brief sentence الحمد لله رب العالمين four times right after you turn to your wife and tell her good morning honey, immediately after that say four times Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. وَمَنْ قَالَهَا إِذَا أَمْسَى when you say it in the evening before you sleep فَقَدْ أَدَّى شُكْرَ لَيْلَتِهِ. If you say it in the morning, you have fulfilled your gratitude to God during the day, and if you say it during the evening, you have fulfilled your gratitude and your thanks to God during the night. وأخيرا, the last hadith عن مولانا وسيدنا أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب عليه الصلاة والسلام. He says, التسبيح نصف الميزان. When you glorify God, subhanallah, it would fill your half of your scale. Half of it, it's going to be filled. والحمد, when you say الحمد لله يملأ الميزان, it's going to fill the entire scale. والله أكبر يملأ ما بين السماوات والأرض. When you say الله أكبر, it's going to fill whatever between the earth and heaven. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا. And the month of Ramadan is concluding. It's concluding. When I was a child in my city, Karbala, I remember during the last days of Ramadan, people would cry and weep because the month is passing and leaving. They would feel sorry because these are the hours of mercy. إنه قد أقبل عليكم شهر الله بالخير والرحمة والبركة. And then the days are the best days, the nights are the best nights, the hours وساعاته أفضل الساعات. شهر دعيتم فيه إلى ضيافة الله وجعلتم فيه من أهل كرامة الله. أنفاسكم فيه تسبيح, نومكم فيه عبادة, عملكم فيه مقبول, دعاؤكم فيه مستجاب. Where do you find such blessings and generosity? When? What season? What other month? Other than Ramadan, the month of Ramadan. We have to feel sorry because the month is coming to conclusion. The month gave us the opportunity to recite Quran. We don't get this opportunity elsewhere. The month gave us the opportunity to recite dua, to celebrate Layali al-Qadr, to say, oh God, I'm sorry. I'm coming back to you. I drifted away from you. Now I'm coming back to you. The month gave us the opportunity to pay some charity, to share our iftar with others, to be nicer to our families, our parents, our children, our neighbors. Where do you get these blessings? So let's take advantage of the three or four more days we have. Most likely Eid is going to be Wednesday. So we have only 4 days left of this month. If you have not done good, you have only 4 days to stand before your Lord and concentrate on your akhir, on your character, on building stronger character. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه, ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وصل اللهم وسلم على خلفاء نبيك وأوصيائه وأهل بيته علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين وعلى البضعة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعلى سبطي نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهما السلام وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والإمام الخلف الهادي المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل مخرجه وجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وقضينا إلى بني إسرائيل في الكتاب لتفسدن في الأرض مرتين ولتعلن علوا كبيرا فإذا جاء وعد أولاهما بعثنا عليكم عبادا لنا أولي بأس شديد فجاسوا خلال الديار وكان وعدا مفعولا ثم رددنا لكم الكرة عليهم وأمددناكم بأموال وبنين وجعلناكم أكثر نفيرا إن أحسنتم أحسنتم لأنفسكم وإن أسأتم فلها فإذا جاء وعد الآخرة ليسوءوا وجوهكم وليدخلوا المسجد كما دخلوه أول مرة وليتبروا ما علوا تتبيرا صدق الله العلي العظيم Today is Yom al-Quds, the day of Jerusalem and Palestine. And Jerusalem has been lost by two culprits. One is the state of Israel that is continuing its occupation, illegal occupation, and merciless and ruthless persecution of the Palestinians in Palestine, in Jerusalem and outside Jerusalem, in Gaza, in the West Bank, in other places, continuing its aggression. And these aggressions has been endorsed and okayed and celebrated by many countries, many permanent members of the Security Council, who are supposed to stand for justice, for peace, for defending the oppressed. They endorse these types of aggressions. And Israel is taking advantage of the weakness of the Muslim Ummah. Why? Because Muslims are fighting each other nowadays. And Muslims are the weakest. Today, the Muslim Ummah is the weakest among all other nations. Because we have an internal bleeding, internal fighting. Countries are fighting each other. Political parties are fighting each other. People are fighting each other. People who are supposed to build their countries, to build hospitals and clinics and schools and homes, they are destroying them. They are destroying them with the money that is supposed to defend Islam, the money that is pouring down on them by Saudi Arabia and Qatar and other countries to destroy the Islamic unity. So Israel is taking advantage of the weakness and the defeat of the Muslim Ummah. And you can see now, Arab countries are rushing to make peace with Israel, spearheaded by Saudi Arabia and Qatar and other Gulf states and other Arab countries and Turkey. Some people are blaming Turkey. Why do you blame Turkey? Turks are not Arabs. If the Arabs are shaking hands with Israel and telling them, you are our friends, despite killing the Palestinians, we need peace with you, then you can't blame Turkey. The second culprit in destroying Jerusalem and abandoning Palestine are the Arab and Muslim countries. some Arab and Muslim countries who betrayed the Palestinian cause, who are focusing now on all their efforts on destroying the Arab Ummah and the Muslim Ummah. They send weapons, they send money, they send recruit fighters, they send them to Iraq, they send them to Syria, they send them to Lebanon, they send them to Egypt, they send them to other places, and they have forgotten their brethren. They have forgotten their brothers and sisters in Palestine. And some of the Palestinians are also to be blamed in this. Not the people of Palestine. Some of the Palestinian organizations, they have a share in this betrayal, the betrayal of their cause. Because of their rift, because of their internal fighting, they don't get together. They are killing each other, fighting each other, calling each other names, and leaving their enemy rejoices. Leaving their enemy becoming more strong and watching them killing each other. Leaving the Palestinian people in hunger, in desperation. I remember one Palestinian leader who died some years ago. He left behind $7 billion. $7 billion in his private account. From where? Why this money has to be private? This money belongs to the Palestinian people. You have to build your country. You have to end the suffering of your country. This is an example, one example. One example. Some Palestinians today, rather than focusing on Palestine and liberating Palestine, they go and fight in other countries. They support the fighting in other countries. This is unacceptable. This is unacceptable. This is what makes this problem of Palestine. This is what prolongs this problem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "In tansuru Allah yansurkum." If you are sincere, I'm going to be sincere too. I'll bring victory upon. In one of the battles, Imam Ali said to his people, "Falamma 'alima Allahu ta'ala minkum as-sabr, anzala 'alaykum an-nasr." When Allah realized that the people are steadfast, the people are sincere and dedicated, they have ikhlas, they are working for the cause of God and humanity, God brought down victory on them. But because many Muslims, they do not have ikhlas. They don't have ikhlas. They are working for their dunya. They are making Palestine business, a supermarket, tijara, business for them. It's not a real cause. If it was a real cause, believe me, they can end the occupation and the suffering within a few days. I would not say a few weeks or months. A few days. Israel is not a strong state. Arabs are weak. Arabs are weak. Israel is taking advantage of our disunity because we are not united, because we are not sincere. Because today we are fighting our Muslim brothers and sisters, mosques are being destroyed, cities populated with civilians is being shelled and destroyed. Look at Iraq, look at Syria, look at Yemen, look at, you know, the weapons of the Muslims today is used against Muslims. This is why nobody is remembering the Palestinians. Because we are busy doing something else. And the Palestinians are forgotten. مَا غُزِيَ قَوْمٌ قَطْ فِي عُقْرِ دَارِهِمْ إِلَّا ذِلُّ. When you allow the enemy to come into your room, into your house, into your backyard, into your territory, and you don't stand for justice, definitely you're going to be humiliated. And this is exactly the condition of the Muslim Ummah today. Humiliation and defeat. The only way to liberate Jerusalem and make it accessible to all religions. Allah wants Jerusalem to be enjoyed by all religions, not just Muslims, not just Jews, not just Christians. All people. Let them enjoy. This is Thalithul Haramain. This is a temple that all religions revere and respect. It has to be open for all. The only way to liberate it from occupation is when Muslims get united and they work sincere. They work sincere. To me, my brothers and sisters, not only Jerusalem is occupied by illegitimate authority, Mecca and Medina is occupied too by illegitimate authority, by Al Saud. And the way to liberate Jerusalem is to liberate Mecca and Medina first. That's the way. That's the truth. This is the reality. As long as Mecca and Medina is occupied by Al Saud and the Wahhabis, it would be a dream, wishful thinking, to liberate Palestine and to liberate Jerusalem. And this is a call for the Muslims to get together, to put the minor differences aside. I am of this madhab and that madhab. I belong to this party and that party. I am this nationality. No. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلٍ. You belong to one family. Even the Muslims and the Jews and the Christians are one family. If they look at their doctrines and their books, they have no conflict. They are one family. Let them get together and work for peace and justice, inshallah ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, most likely the Eid is going to be most likely on Monday. Monday is July 4th. Yeah, we will see fireworks, but not then. Most likely on Wednesday, but we're going to announce that on Monday we send an email. So please don't call and ask by telephone. Telephone, this is outdated, you know. So email, you receive an email Monday night. If there is no observation of moon in California or the neighboring states or the neighboring countries, then we would issue a statement. And Tuesday is going to be the 30th of, today is the 26th, Tuesday is going to be the 30th, and Wednesday is going to be the beginning of Shawwal. And Zakatul Fitr, my dear brothers and sisters, is $15 per person. You pay it on the day of Eid. On the day of Eid, you pay Zakatul Fitr. We're going to put boxes here for those who would like to pay the Zakatul Fitr. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'mineen wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat tabi' allahumma baynana wa baynahum bil khayrat innaka mujibud da'awat. Allahumma wahhid kalimatal muslimin ala al khayri wal birri was salahi wat taqwa ya arhamar rahimin munna ala mardana bil shifa'i wal afiyah وعجل في فرج سيدنا ومولانا صاحب العصر والزمان وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد.